this way. Can't get it now, so stay with me. It's not like we got big plans. Let's drive around town holding hands. And I need to know you're the only one. Alright, alright. And I need to know that you keep me up all night. All night, yeah. Oh, my heart, it's so good. How I love you, yeah. So bad, so bad.
Somehow you supposed to be a walk in the park. If it was, we'd all have it. It's more like a blindfold reaching the dark, and you're lucky if you can grab it. Now your hands in mine, I'm gonna keep you close. No matter what curves the road's gonna throw, we won't let go. 'Cause we both know we're gonna be the strong ones, still standing when the hell comes, still running when the well runs dry, still believing when the sun don't shine, ain't afraid of a hard day's night, won't quit when it don't go right, let the world bring it then some. Girl, we're gonna be the tough ones, yeah, the tough ones. Some days that'll give us all we can take, but we won't back down, we'll make it through somehow if we lean on love and faith. We're never gonna break, we're gonna be the strong. Standing when the hell comes, still running when the well runs dry, still believing when the sun don't shine, ain't afraid of a hard day's night, won't quit when it don't go right, let the world bring it then some. Girl, we're gonna be the tough ones, let the world bring it then some. Girl, we're gonna be the tough. Yeah, the tough ones.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment and each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so. And she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman with you be the same freckle-faced kid that I knew, one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights? And I knew the first time I saw,
and confidently put it in the hand of this man, knowing that you have done well that very sacred moment upon your altar.
Are you with her? It was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and I played
here to declare some very sacred vows to love her, to comfort her, to honor her, and to keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping her himself only unto her. And likewise, we have Louise here today that is saying that has come to with the intent of making these same vows at God's holy altar.
It's in my heart, will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first.
Timing.
From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through, when a miracle smiles up at you. I loved her first.
Ray, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me. I, Ray, take thee, Louise.
I, Ray, take thee, Louise.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto do I.
And thereto do I.
Give thee my pledge.
Give thee my pledge.
Amen. Louise, are you ready for this? Yes, beautiful. Okay, you're going to repeat after me. I, Louise, take thee, Ray. To be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance. And thereto do I give thee my pledge. Amen. Wonderful.
I feel it in my finger. I feel it in my toe. Love is all around me, and so the feeling grows. It's written on the wind, it's everywhere I go. Oh, yes it is. So if you really love me, come on and let it show. All my love, you can be mine.
again of all the things you said. Oh, yes, I did.
You gave your promise to me, and I give mine to you. I need someone beside me in everything I do.
Officiating minister, family and friends. My name is Tubal. As the officiating master of ceremonies has said, and if you all don't know, I am the cousin of Reynard. And it gives me a great joy and a pleasure this afternoon to say a few words about my cousin. I promise I won't be long, as once I get started, I tend to go on and on and on. But I'm sure my wife will give me the heads up. And I just need to remember that this is not my wedding, but somebody else's. On thinking of what to say today at Reynard's wedding, you know, like everybody nowadays, we go on to the internet and go on to Google. And I saw how to say the perfect wedding speech. And there was 5 tips that came up. Number one, it says, remember who's in the audience, right? That's not going to be very difficult because of the amount of people that we have here today. Record yourself while practicing, which I didn't do. Avoid alcohol prior to speaking, which is not a problem with me because everybody knows I don't drink. Use note cards if needed. Keep it short and sweet, okay? I was shocked to see that there was nothing about being yourself and being honest. So I guess they expect you to lie. But the truth is that I don't need to lie when it comes to Reynard. A gentleman, and I'm sure Louise will agree, a father and a friend, a companion, a cousin, and now a husband. Reynard and I grew up together, and I spent many school holidays with him and his family in Phoenix. We were never naughty children, but I think my mom may disagree with me about me. And we enjoyed our time playing outside in the yard and playing tennis on the road. He is a very responsible young man, and even at a small age, I remember when we used to accompany his mom to the White House supermarket to buy vegetable with her, he used to choose the veggies for her, right? Ensuring that she only picked or he only got the good quality vegetables. And I think his passion for quality led him to choose a career in food safety. His high school years was at Daleview Secondary and then went on to study environmental health at ML Sultan Technikon. Growing up, Reynard was a disciplined young man who loved his pets to bits, not forgetting Bronson, making sure that he was fed and cleaned and at times kept indoors. He is an avid snooker player, right? A great swimmer as well, who also enjoys fishing. Many a days we spent at the swimming pool. Reynard was so meticulous that during Diwali, which we don't celebrate, the fireworks that we had was a well laid out plan of which we were going to light first and the time we were going to light it, and it was all set in a row, ready to be lit. Things were not easy at first, but Reynard has persevered and has made great bounds to the successful young man you see in front of you today. A caring and a loving man who believes and trusts in God and a go-getter. Always willing to assist those who need help and passionate about getting what he wants. So I guess that's why Louise is sitting next to him. Ray, I leave you and Louise with an ever so famous scripture on love in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Remember this, Ray. Love is patient. Love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror, when we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And for now, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of this is love. Thank you very much.
Started 6 years ago, the cup of sugar. But if you want to know what happened to sugar, I'll say, I don't know. Very sweet.
All the time.
I never lost a daughter. I gained a son. So thank you for that. Louise always said that. Reynard doesn't want to ask questions. I said, Louise, God will provide when you will ask questions. And eventually, 6 years later, it happened. So that's why everybody came to him through this venue with him. Just remember, Ray, I told you there's no refund on it. You keep up.
Good day, everyone, and welcome. Can we all just take a moment just to look at our beautiful bride here today? She's absolutely stunning. The dress, the makeup, the crown, everything. And as for our groom, looking dashing as always. Yes. Better than other days, of course. But anyway, I just want to thank all of you all for being here today. And we want to really thank you all. And we really appreciate every single one of y'all that is here. And so, anyway, I met Louise 6 years ago, and I can say that we had our ups and downs. There was the good, there was the bad, and there was the ugly. But of course, during all of this, we grew through all of that, and we became extremely close to each other. And I would just like to say that Louise, I really thank you for coming into my life and for accepting me for who I am and for loving me like I'm your own son. And, and basically just making me feel loved when mom couldn't. So, and to dad as well for looking after me and both of you being there for me for all the bad times and the struggles. And once again, thank you all so much for being here today. May God bless you all, and we all have a wonderful night. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. First and foremost, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank God for saving me and granting me life and good health again. I would also like to give sincere thanks to my family, my parents, my sisters, my brother, for all that they've done for me. My parents for raising me to be an independent person that I am today, and for always being there for me during my trials and tribulations. I thank them dearly, and I pray only for blessings and good health upon them. Just 8 months ago, as Pastor Craig has mentioned, I was gravely ill with COVID in hospital, and I was in ICU. I was sick for about 3 months. Couldn't walk, couldn't speak, couldn't breathe. I had to learn how to walk again and speak. I'm very, very grateful that I'm standing here right now to see all of you attend this wedding. During that time in hospital, I didn't think I was going to make it. And people were actually preparing for the worst, preparing for my funeral. And 8 months later, we celebrate our wedding. You know, life is unpredictable, and the last 2 years, COVID has taught everybody how precious life is. And you're here today, and you can be gone tomorrow. During that time when I was sick, there were a few other people that I knew also had the virus, and both of them passed away in 5 days. It took me 3 months of recovery, but to get to where I am today took me 6 months to walk by myself, to be strong again, and to stand upright and speak by myself, and being able to drive and do everything that I can do as I used to do. So yes, life is very unpredictable. Anyway, today's our wedding. We're not going to be, it's not a sad story, it's an exciting event. And I'm so glad to see all of you here. And yes, You all look tops. Spiffing. Looking good. I'm glad. Not better than us, but looking good. So, after 8 years, this day is funny, right? It's actually 8 years that we know each other and been together for 8 years, but been nagging to marry for the last 6 years. So, yes, I'm a bit slow. I do understand that. I'm not always that focused. I'm always thinking of other things rather than marriage. But yes, COVID was an awakening for me. And I realized that if I don't do it now, I'm never gonna do it. And I have the second chance to do it. So we were gonna do it anyway. So I said, yes, this is the time before it's too late. And I'm glad I made the right decision. Baby, I would like to thank you personally. I know I've done it so many times. For the time that I was sick, let me tell you something. Louise showed me how caring she can be, how loving and compassionate and selfless. I couldn't even go to the bathroom when I came out of the hospital, but she helped me with everything. There were nights where I couldn't sleep because I was in so much pain and I couldn't breathe. She would not sleep. She would stay awake and watch me to make sure that I don't pass out or stop breathing. I lost so much of weight during that time that I couldn't walk properly at all. And when I started learning how to walk again, my muscles in my legs deteriorated so much and it pained every night. So bad that I used to cry. She would sit on the bed and massage my legs till the sun came up. And I'm not lying. Until I was okay. My body ached every day. She didn't sleep. So I want to thank her. She healed me. God healed me spiritually. She healed me physically. She was there for me. So I'm truly grateful to her, and I'm absolutely lucky to have her in my life. Baby, I do love you very, very much. And I know sometimes you may think that I don't show it that much because I'm always busy, because I work, we have a business. So yes, I am busy, I love it. But please never ever forget that I do truly love you. And whenever I'm not with you, you can ask Brightness and Kate. I'm always talking about you. Even when you irritate me, I'm still talking about you. So yes, guys, it's our wedding. We are very happy. We are glad to see every single one of you here. I'd like to thank you once again for attending and for taking the time and effort to be here today. We are really very grateful to all of you for being here. Pastor Shirley and Pastor Craigie, thank you very much. I put them on the spot on Wednesday this week, and I asked them to please MC this event for us. So they had 2 days notice. That's it. So very glad that they were able to do it. Arnon, thank you very much, you and your family, for the transport. Cars tops, one day I'll have one just like that. And every single one of you seated here, family, friends, for attending and sharing this day with us. We really appreciate it. Michael, speech was excellent. Chubo, thank you. Auntie Malinga and Auntie Mabel, I am so happy to see both of you here. I haven't seen you guys in years. Tasha, Natalie, I haven't seen you in about maybe 5 to 10 years. I haven't seen you guys. I'm very happy to see you. Mr. Michael Kiro, I need to thank you as well for giving me such a beautiful daughter. Your daughter, my wife now. Thank you very much. And for Louise's aunt for attending, thank you very much for driving through from Peterborough, both of you, Uncle Shane, you as well. And Uncle Brahm, he drove all the way from Johannesburg this morning to be here. So we're very grateful for that, but to have him here as well. My friends in the corner there, Chris, keeping quiet.
The cheap seat,
right in the corner. We got a toast next, I hope you realize that. I hope you're ready. Guys, thank you very much. Very, very, very much. Enjoy. Please be relaxed. Don't stress about anything. Eat as much as you want to drink. There is a bar. Unfortunately, it's not an open bar. Can't afford an open bar. It's a cash bar. Please enjoy yourselves and relax. And enjoy this time and this evening with us. Thank you very much.
As you all heard, Ray went through a tough time, the COVID and all that. Louise standing behind him all the way. I was one of those guys when she phoned me or I found out that Ray had the COVID. What I told her is kick him, beat him up, tell him to get up, no time to lay down. Well, I've known Ray for more than 12 years. I've lived in Newcastle before that. He moved up there to come and join me at the abattoir. The first day I found out that he was going to start there, I said, who is this new guy going to start? Yeah, so yeah, after that we moved. I moved to Dundee a few years later when I left the abattoir. Then a few months later I realized that Ray was around there playing pool and we met up again. And then one night walking, and Louise was walking from work, very hard working person, she walked about 8 k's, maybe 12 k's home, and it was pouring outside. I was inside the buggy and we drove past her. Ray turned around and I said to him to pick her up. I had to get onto the back of the buggy and it was pouring. We dropped Louise at home and then went home. And then after that, a few years later, down the road, 8 years later, they're getting married now. And yeah, happy for you guys, eh? That's all, thank you.
I am Louise's spiritual mom, and if you know that a few years ago her biological mom passed away, and I stand in the gap for her. And I just want to say a few words on behalf of my spiritual daughter today, if that's okay. Like Douglas said, she is a very hard-working person. She works to the bone. She really truly is growing and evolving into that beautiful Proverbs 31 woman where she keeps the midnight oil burning and she knows how to allow Ray, her husband now, but then her husband to be. She knows how to cause him to make his name great and his name to be praised at the city gate according to the word. Louise, you and I have something in common. I see you met your husband in a very similar fashion that I met my husband. Let me tell you about me. So when I finished matric, I moved to live with my aunt and uncle in Shawcross because I was working at the Natal Blood Transfusion Service. And I used to stand somewhere, if anyone from Chatsworth, Shawcross area here? I see quite a few Indians here. Oh, sir. Okay. All right. Shawcross, Chatsworth area. There is that turn off that the bus goes on that route. Praise, just help me. You know, I'm not a Durban girl. I'm from Maritzburg. What is that? Unit 9. So I used to stand there and wait for my lift. And my husband was obviously used to drive past, and you know all the guys that used to hoot, he was one of them that used to hoot when I was standing on the road for a lift. The only difference, Louise, I didn't get into the car. Okay, I didn't get into the car. But nonetheless, God is so great. God is so great. And if I'm saying my joke, and it's not a joke, it's a real thing. If I'm saying it incorrectly, it's just because Ray didn't give us time to prepare. But God is so good. When He wants two people to come together, He has a beautiful way of bringing them together. Because when it so happened that my husband was working at King Edward Hospital. So when he came into the blood bank, I saw this guy coming in, squinting and looking at me. And then he was, you know, he wasn't a man of many words then. And so his pickup line was, am I included in your plans for the weekend? And then the rest is history. Okay, so for Louise, you've worked so hard. She wakes up and attends pre-COVID. She would attend the sisters' meetings at 6 a.m. in the morning. She'll travel out and she will make those meetings. She's a woman who prays hard. She knows the altar. She recognizes holy things. And I know that their marriage and their family is going to be really blessed because she knows how to love hard, she knows how to give hard, and she knows how to serve hard. So today I'm so proud to stand in the gap for her biological mom, sir, and also as her spiritual guide that God had seen fit for to bring her into my life. So God bless you all, and let's party. Let the party begin.
I think I just got put on the spot here a little bit. So thanks, Ray, for all of this. I really appreciate it. So just to fill you in, Ray and I started playing pool together many, many years ago. Started more out as sort of enemies competing against each other, a lot of rivalry, and turned into teammates, and now turned into very good friends, and look forward to growing that friendship for many, many years to come. So yeah, it's been a great time and many more years, great years to look ahead. As for that lovely bride over there, the problem with coming last to say your little say is that every single person over here is pretty much taken a piece from one and filled it in. So yeah, to the bride, you guys, or you look amazing. Ray, not too shabby. Yeah, so from my side, what I wanted to say is my wife, lovely wife over there, Hayley, we've been married for almost 7 years, coming up in 2 months time, so 7 years of marriage. Yeah, there's some great times and there's going to be some tough times, and all I can say from that is love brought you guys here today, and love is something that's going to keep you guys going for many, many years to come. So all I can say is I wish you the best, and I'll always be here for you guys if you ever need anything. And yeah, hope everyone has a wonderful day. Enjoy your day. Toast. I need one of those. Okay. Can we Bluetooth it? So toast to Ray and Louise. May you guys be blessed with many, many happy years. And thanks for an awesome day. Cheers. Love you guys.
Yes.
Yes.